Who doesn't deserve water? Who deserves a better quality of water than others? Everybody needs water. You can't turn anyone away, and you can't devalue the human race. The church has always been a community base to bring resources to people that's lacking. It was evident that needs were to be provided for water. I've been serving here at this church for 5 years, and upon our assignment here, it was right at the beginning of the water crisis of April 2014.
And Flint, poor Flint, challenges the conscience of America that these children would be subjected to that poisonous water affecting their brain and their futures.
People around the world think that the problem in Flint is totally just non-existent anymore. They think that it got solved and that's why it's not being reported on. And it's just not true. The problems have not been solved. People cannot drink the water. It's just that simple. It's just been declining for the past 5 years. It started off with like 5 million bottles the first year, and then it was like 3, and then 2, and then this year it's going down to like 800,000. So it's like they need to have a backbone for them to rely on.
We need help because our man force here at the church, no spring chickens, you know.
About 2 years ago, I started looking at how we could be more of a service from an engineering standpoint and starting to help places that were having stressed water issues. And so that's why we came to Flint.
Our work kind of spoke for itself, and it got the attention of Jaden and Drew. They had heard about some of the work that we have already been doing here at the church and reached out to us in a very grassroots way. It wasn't so much as to what can we do for you. It was more so what can we do together. And so they came down, we had a meeting, and just kind of brainstormed some ideas, bounced some ideas off, and then came the water box.
This machine can filter 10 gallons every 60 seconds.
When this crisis hit, we couldn't necessarily fend for our own city with our own resources. And so for me, my mindset is that if something else happened, we can build from within.
We're kind of trying to give First Trinity their own source of clean water instead of having to rely on donations of water or buying water.
This is tested by the church on site here.
Once we figured out what the actual water box will do, it was time for the engineering component to take place.
Water box.
I'm very, very surprised as well as humbled that they would make such a gesture.
Our reach. We've been able to service so many more families, so many more households.
They sent me into one of the jobs.
It's essentially still kind of a water drive-through, but they're able to come with their own jugs or container for us to fill up with the water box, and then they get in their car and they're on their way.
Thank you.
Having this water box is a step in the right direction for helping those in our community who are often overlooked.
I just told Drew that I personally like to donate another water box. So
God opened another door.
You have shown what it means to care, and you said this is about a mission, and it's about the mission of Flint Lives Mattering. So thank you. You
know, they talk about America and we have our problems, but the Americans are you and I and First Trinity and all the others out here that are doing what we do, and it's the best place in the world to live.
Now we're here and it's running, and I think it's the most powerful thing I've ever been a part of in my life.
We did it. We just launched
the water box. Yes. I'm so excited. It was a long time coming, and we're here to service the community, and we just hope to do more and to continue to create change here in Flint and all over the world.
Clean water for Flint. Yes. This water box is more than just a box. It's really a glimpse of what hope looks like for the city of Flint.
I see hope in another generation who has chose not to leave, to stick and stay, to build.
There's so much more work that needs to be done. There's so much more infrastructure that needs to be put into place. And this, we're really just hoping, is a call to action to everyone around the world to say, hey, there's all types of problems that are going on, but we can really put our heads together and make long-lasting, efficient solutions.
We're optimistic that hopefully one of these days we can say we're out of crisis mode, but while we're still in it, we have a water box to help us.